You ready? Are you going to give him a name?
Georgie Jackson.
Oh, nice.
Grade 3 students from Spring Valley Elementary are loading up little fish, or fry, in plastic bags to be transported to the spawning channel at Mission Creek Park.
I grabbed the fish with my partner, and then we set them go into the creek.
Aren't you allergic to fish?
Yeah, but it's really only if I eat it, but I have to be cautious if I touch them.
Okay, so you didn't touch them?
No.
We put them in for 10 seconds to make sure they were adjusted to the creek water, then we let them go. I think we teach this fish the fastest.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's we're all the way up there. All right.
Is it sad letting the fish go? You're not going to see him again?
Yeah, kind of. I'm going to miss Super Swimmer. That's what he names. Super Swimmer. I think it fits in.
Southern Rider, Northern Rider, and Ghost Rider.
Why?
Because I like the movie Ghost Rider.
The kids have been raising these Super Swimmers since the early fall while learning the life cycle of the salmon.
It goes from egg-eyed egg with one little eye, two-eyed egg, 11, fry, and then adults and spawners. The spawners, they spawn the eggs, and then they die.
What stage are they at today? What do you call that?
Fry.
Fry, okay. And how old would they be, do you know?
Probably 3 months old.
They're going to somewhere peaceful and shady.
Who worked on this station here? So what was the problem that you had to solve?
The students also got to build dams and retaining pools and experiment with farming and railroads, all in a mini watershed.
Well, the idea is to give the kids an understanding of the watersheds that we live in and how we interact in that watershed. And we try to paint a real picture of it. So we've got our rain coming down and it's flowing into our stormwater retention pond. And the thunderstorm has stopped now and the rain's no longer coming there. And we will see some of it coming out because that's what we would expect. But remember when we did it before, it all went and by now the whole river was green. Good job, guys. Excellent job.
The little creek creates realistic situations faced by humans after they build and live in a real watershed.
When this stream is flooding, it's staying within its banks except for where it's low in a floodplain. And if we fill up the floodplain, it's just going to flood somewhere else. You know, they call this being out in the bush, today in the park. That's as much of the bush as they will ever get. So by bringing them in and having a visual for them, they'll start to understand, hopefully, what they do can affect the environment either in a positive or a negative way.
Back at the real creek, these little fry now face a lot of predators and obstacles on their journey out to the lake and back again.
Well, there's the natural predators, of course, like herons and eagles and the bears that'll come up the spawning channel to get the adult kokanee. But there's also a lot of pollution and that kind of thing. Storm drain runoff. And there's also natural occurring disasters that happen, like droughts and... There's a lot of dangers for the little guys. It's actually only 2% of the fish that naturally are spawning. The eggs will go to adults and spawn again. There's only 2% of them that do. So these students are doing a really big favor to the kokanee, taking them all the way from eggs to fry.
So this fish you let go today is going to come back later on, right, and lay eggs?
Yeah, and then it's going to be big, and then it's going to lay eggs. We're going to come back sometime around. Like last year, I remember we came here and we... looked at all the fish, like the red and green one. We even saw some dead ones. It was cool.
Fish are cool, right?
Yeah, fish are cool. I like them. They're cool because they don't have lungs. They breathe through water, and there's oxygen in the water, so they can breathe.